I greet you all this blessed moment as I present to you this edition of the Lesson of Life series. The previous presentation was based on the subject, Stop the Negative Thinking. And the take-home message was actually from one of my favorite quotes from Maya Angelou. She said, "You may not control all the events that may happen to you, but you can certainly decide not to be reduced by them." If you haven't seen that presentation yet, I will post the link along with today's presentation. So following up with today's presentation, the subject for today is based on never surrender to failure. Never surrender to failure. So what does it mean to surrender? The Webster Dictionary defines the word as to yield to the power of something upon demand, or to cease resistance in order to submit to the authority of something. Combining these two definitions, therefore, we can rephrase today's message as do not submit to the authority of failure. Do not submit to the authority of failure. Many a times, we set ambitions for ourselves, we set goals for ourselves at different points in time. However, as time goes on, as situations do not favor us, or as situations do not go as we expected or planned it, we are therefore easily convinced to give up on that ambition that we had initially set for ourselves. Hence, we become stagnant and do not see any progress forward. So, the purpose of failure, if you think about it, the purpose of failure is not meant for you to give up, but rather it's meant to challenge you not to give up. So, how do you challenge yourself not to give up? Here are some suggested ways in order to not give up. And I use the word suggested because your situation may be different from mine, and the obstacles that may come in your way may definitely be also different from the obstacles that will come my way. So the first way is to have a defined ambition. Have a defined ambition. That is having an understanding of what your ambition is about. What are the different options that are involved in achieving that ambition? There are many ways to skin a cat. So my way will definitely be different from your way of achieving your ambition. And the second thing is also to have a positive mindset towards that ambition. Have a positive mindset towards that ambition. Don't let negativity seize your mind from realizing the positive things in your life. And remember that you will be presented with different obstacles, different difficulties at different points in time. However, in all, be positive minded. Whatever your ambition is, one way to achieve that is having a positive mindset towards that ambition. The third way is to set priorities for yourself. What can you do now versus what can you do at some point in time? Set priorities for yourself. Know what is more important now versus what's more important later on in life. And the fourth thing is to surround yourself with people that will push you towards your ambition. Surround yourself with people that will push you towards your ambition. As the saying goes, show me your friend and I'll show you who you are. And also, birds of the same feathers flock together. And as my friend Sean Ryan said, he said, you don't need an army of fake friends, but rather you need a few friends who will take on an army with you because they love you. So surround yourself with people that will push you towards achieving your ambition. And lastly, stay focused. Stay focused. That is the most important thing. Stay focused. You'll be faced with different difficulties. You'll be criticized constructively. You would also be criticized destructively. You will make mistakes at some point. You are definitely going to fail at some point. But in all this, however, remember that yesterday is a closed door. You don't need it anymore. Therefore, be careful not to surrender to the authority of failure, else you will miss the opportunities ahead. Be careful not to submit to the authority of failure, else you will miss the opportunities ahead. I hope to present to you another edition of the Lesson of Life series. Enjoy a blessed rest of the week, and I will speak to you again soon. God bless you.